Get ready to match the stars from Shannara Bowser, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Chips, Breanne Leary, from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, and George Guillemot, as we play the star-studded big money match game, BM. And now, here's the star of match game BM, Gene Rayburn.
Hey, John. Thank you very much for joining us. Hi, you look ready. Put the blouse on the other way next time, and then we're going to be all right. Let's say hello to Bob McConnell and Kathy Gibson. We welcome both of you. Want to find out a little bit about each of you? We'll all get acquainted here. Kathy, what do you have to say about yourself?
Well, I'm a homemaker in Upland, California, and I have two children, a little boy 5, a little girl that's 8. And I like to keep busy. I'm PTA president. I like to play tennis and ski, and I just started playing racquetball.
Well, that's good to be that active. Was that one of your kids out there shouting?
No, they're not that old.
Oh, they're not.
The racquetball part.
All right. Bob, what do you have to say for Bob McConnell?
Well, I've just recently moved here from Maine, and I'm living now in Orange County. And I came out here just to visit for a while, but I've turned into a stay. And I like playing backgammon quite a bit. I teach it. And
you do?
Yes. And I've taken a liking to swimming. Since I've been out here.
That's a wonderful exercise, yes.
It's a good exercise.
We have someone else in the group who's from Maine,
right,
and who came here and decided to stay, too. Much
I
to
never
the...
took to swimming.
But she's got the water wings for it, I'll tell you that. Here on Match Game PM, each of you will have 3 opportunities to match as many of them as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often will be the winner, and that person will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. Here we go. Kathy, you want A or B? Kathy says she wants A. Here it is. Fred said, my goldfish is a real name dropper. He claims that he knows blank personally. My goldfish is a real name dropper. He claims that he knows blank personally.
I'm going to talk in a Maine accent for the entire show.
Well, how come you don't talk in a Maine accent?
He do.
I'm closer to Boston.
I see. Oh. Put it in a slot, Bowser.
Put me all in a slot.
Yeah. Fred said my goldfish is a real name dropper. He claims that he knows blank personally.
Charlie the Tuna?
Charlie the Tuna. Good. That's kind of a nifty answer, isn't it?
I personally happen to love that answer. The reason that I love it so much, Gene, is because I put it. Charlie the Tuna.
Charlie the Tuna.
I hope I spelled everything right, that's all.
I see. If the grease drips off your hair, what do we do? Do we call a fire department or anything? Is it flammable?
Just bring me in for an oil change,
Jerry. Yeah, all right. Have you been fire retarded?
Yep. Boom.
Just the last part.
Right.
Leave out the fire.
Shows
what
the
part of Maine is Bob from?
From the southern part, he said.
Well, that's where I'm from. Where are you from?
Portland.
Me too, dear.
Right.
Hang right in there. I love him saying. Did you hear him say Boston?
I did.
I said Neptune.
Neptune.
Claims he knows Neptune personally.
Mine stinks,
that's not right.
Too.
Really?
Davy Jones.
Davy Jones.
Davy Jones.
Funny.
Thank
you. There's another. Breanne, let's see your card now.
Mine is a very cosmopolitan French fish, Jacques Cousteau.
Oh, Jacques Cousteau. Goldfish is a real name dropper. He claims that he knows blank personally. Charlie the Tuna is the answer that Kathy gave us. What do you say?
I have discovered, as your guest, that it's always good when you can get off to a nice start with your audience, because
right,
they can become vicious.
Oh, yes.
I said Charlie the Tuna.
Now, Bob.
Yes,
right, I
would
say.
Well, I frankly will admit that I enjoy your applause, and if you wish to applaud me again, go right ahead.
records this.
Listen,
and plays
Johnny,
it at night.
I know you're on his payroll, but this is ridiculous.
You may applaud me anytime you wish, and it is not necessary to laugh at anything Gene says tonight.
Thanks, Lee. Okay, Joyce, we're up to you.
I said new Esther Williams.
Everybody knows Esther Williams personally. She spent a lot of time underwater. That's the idea, I suppose. Okay, let's see what we've got from the fella from Maine. The produce man said, something really strange happened today. Who's speaking?
The produce man.
Thank you.
You are, Gene.
You did, okay.
Did I have a glazed look in my eyes?
Yes, you did. He says, something really strange happened today. A kissing bandit came into the market and started kissing my blanks.
Kissing
my blanks.
Kissing his blanks. The produce man.
The produce man.
Kissing
bandit
his
came into the market and started kissing my blanks. Chuck is ready. The produce man, something really strange happened today. A kissing bandit came into the market and started kissing my blanks.
Oranges. Orange County.
Don't you go.
Well, he said he was from Orange County.
Maybe he meant his navel oranges.
Oh, his navel oranges, yeah. What do you got there?
I was truly thinking, I think, of a produce man's wife, and I put melons.
Melons. Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
No, thank you.
I won't have a fellow maniac booed. Now, you're not to boo him.
Don't boo him.
Don't boo him. Unfortunately, I didn't say what he said. I said, started kissing my banana.
I see. I don't think nobody's going to say what he said. What do you say?
Another terrible answer, but it's true. Fig leaves.
Fig leaves.
Makes some sense. Makes sense to me.
No comment. A kissing bandit came into the market, started kissing my...
My radishes.
My radishes.
Well, excuse me. I'm sorry, I'm alive.
You are a weirdo.
Foxes.
Hello there, Bob.
Why don't you just go right on to Joyce?
No, no. That's all right. You got a rotten answer, you got to show it anyway.
Well, we're kind of running late now.
All right ahead, Bob.
That is, have a go.
Well, I'm glad this audience likes me. Yeah. I said broccoli.
Broccoli. Now, you must admit, that is a perfectly dreadful answer. Makes no sense whatsoever.
Poor Bob said he
was... We liked it, didn't we, folks?
Wrong! Wrong! You're a bunch of weirdos!
Yeah. Incidentally, I have refrigerators for all of you.
Okay.
Joyce. I haven't got refrigerators. I haven't anything as cold as that.
What have you got for us?
I think the Lord. Kissing bandit got turned on by his turnips.
Turnips. Okay. So there we are, in round one. 2-0 in favor of Kathy. Round two coming up in a moment. So right now, this for America. Here we go. Yes. Round two coming up here. Kathy, you're ahead, so we're going to ask you to go first.
I'll try B.
B. Okay, you match two people in the first round, so those two will lay out. John, and what's his name? Did you hear that Billy Carter is opening a chain of private taverns? No. Did you hear about that?
No.
Yes. They're going to be called Billy Blanks. Chain of private taverns.
Taverns. They're going to be called...
This is Billy Carter.
Billy Broccoli.
Billy the Tuna.
Oh, he thinks he's got a good answer, so he's afraid. Have I looked in his direction once in the last 6 years? Maybe not. What's he got? Is he good?
I don't speak to Chinese women.
Go. Put an answer down. We need an answer from you, Brianne.
Oh, right now? I'm sorry.
I mean, in the slot. That's it, because the light goes on after you do that. Kathy, did you hear that Billy Carter is opening a chain of private taverns? They're going to be called Billy Blanks.
Billy Bars.
Billy Bars. Billy Bars. Okay. What do you say, Brett?
I skimmed right over that. I threw that out.
Billy Bars, you threw it out?
What is that? Is that?
No, I don't know. That's what she said.
I said Billy Beers.
Billy Beers. That's the name of his beer.
Is there a definitive answer?
I don't think so.
I think there is. Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
Billy Club.
Billy Club, that's a definitive answer. Billy Club, just a little play on words there. That's the nightstick that the policemen use. It's called a Billy Club. What did you have?
Billy's Peanut Bars. Same thing. I meant bars. Like I said, bars. To be
well,
cute.
The word bars isn't it? So that's not keeping it. Pat and Alex, three. Bryce, what do you have?
Something kind of strange.
Yeah. You have a strange answer? That'll be a novelty.
Billy Boozer Taverns.
Billy Boozer Taverns.
Boozer. That's Bowser.
That's Bowser, right.
Not Boozer.
Okay, Bob, you ready for yours? All right.
Okay.
Here it is. Gloria said, over the summer, my son grew a foot. Unfortunately, he grew it on his blank.
Some people have all the luck.
Right. Okay.
That's better.
All right. Here we go. Gloria said, over the summer, my son grew a foot. Unfortunately, he grew it on his blank.
His leg.
Not the hop. In Anatomy 1, you learn that a foot is attached to the leg, you see.
Right. He grew another one.
I see.
Three.
Okay.
What did he say, dear?
He said his leg.
Oh, his leg?
Yeah.
I grew a foot over the summer, too, but why did I have to dress it like this, Gene?
I wonder.
Well, I didn't say leg either. I said midriff.
Midriff.
Meaning belly, stomach.
That would be a very funny sight.
Come on, lay it on.
Yes. That's rather...
Go ahead, get it out. Come on.
They love you, Jenny.
Come on, don't say that.
Okay.
I love him. He interprets booze as applause. It's the perfect adjustment to make.
It's the beauty of my profession.
Today's world.
They're booing you and you haven't even shown it to him yet.
Wait till she gives me the answer. I'll kill you.
I want you all to simmer down, or you're going to be sent to your room.
Simmer down,
dear. Simmer down, dear. Oh, the end of his nose.
The end of his nose is a funny part. Yes.
The end of his head.
His head would be good.
The end of your career.
The end of his career.
But those are all funny sights. Brienne?
I said he grew a foot on his hand. Isn't
hand,
that...
another good answer. Yep. There you go.
Come on.
I love that kind of talk.
Leave him alone.
In keeping with trying to make my answers as logical as possible, if broccoli...
They're watching, Bob.
If you're going to be that funny, you come up here. What I started to say is that if you did grow, a young man grows during the summer, he grows taller.
Right.
And so he grew the foot on his head.
Uh-huh.
You see?
Yeah.
Certain of them are turning on
the
you.
Long explanations what don't does that help say? Any.
Depraved.
Yes.
She has a thing. Did you see that?
Yes, I see that.
Yeah. There's a sign pointing to me that says depraved.
She got it from
I'll
Dorothy
just move
Joe.
It on. Yes.
Okay, what do you got there, Joyce?
I have an ear. He grew
an ear. Okay. All right, we go to round three. Kathy is still ahead. We'll ask you to go first.
Okay, I'll try A again.
A it is. A says, Mary the musician said, Santa Claus must be getting senile. This year I asked him for a French horn. Instead, Santa gave me a French blank. You don't play, you don't play.
He's still my heart.
No.
All yours, baby.
Right.
I don't play. Okay. Should it be this? Ah.
All right, Kathy. Mary the musician said, Santa Claus must be getting senile. This year I asked him for a French horn. Instead, Santa gave me a French blank.
Made.
Oh, no!
Is that the first thing that came to your mind?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
It is.
All right.
She said a French maid.
Maid.
Yes.
Oh, it's a perfect answer. I wish I thought of it myself, but I didn't.
You don't play. It's a good answer.
Right, no.
I said that what he gave her was a little French kiss.
Yeah!
They're crazy about me. These are my kind of people.
No, they just like French kissing a lot. Okay.
Well, come on
up. Okay, Chuck.
So sad.
Kiss, okay. All right, Joyce. Show us your French kiss.
I had the perfect answer, yours, written down here, and these two...
No, I didn't. I like...
These
no,
two
I...
made me say this.
I did not.
Okay.
No.
So she remains at three, and Bob, that means you need three to tie and four to win. Here it is. Susie the Starlet said the audition for that movie was like a visit to the doctor's office. The first thing the producer asked me to do was blink. Right? Okay. Bob McConnell, are you ready for this?
I'm ready, Gene.
All right. Here we go. Susie the Starlet said the audition for that movie was like a visit to the doctor's office. The first thing the producer asked me to do was blank.
Take off my clothes.
Okay. You're the depraved ones. You are. This audience. Okay, Bows, go.
Well, strip.
That's it. There's one. Yes.
Barbara didn't say take off my clothes if you were still in Maine. You've gotten trashy since you've come out here, dear. Remove my garments.
Remove my garments. All right. Yeah.
Go. Hey up. Is that what you said? Hey up.
Strip,
baby.
Strip, baby. Okay. Score is now tied 3-3. You need one more to win the game. Let's see what Breanne has.
I was debating. I thought it's psychiatrist is either lie down on the couch.
Yeah.
Or take off the clothes.
So that wins the game. What do you have, Bob?
Take off my clothes.
Kathy, it was a pleasure to meet you. Kathy Gibson, ladies and gentlemen. There she goes. Let's spin her off and spin a message for America. How do you feel? Time now for the Big Money Super Match, where this fella can win over $20,000. To do that, we have two audience matches for you. Let's go with the first one. We polled a studio audience, said write down your best answer to this. Doll blank, $500 for matching their most popular answer, for matching the second most popular, $250, and $100 for the third. Three of our six stars will help you.
Well, I like to pick Bowser.
Oh, I would say to that doll house.
Okay. Of course, Brett. Doll baby.
Okay.
And Bob.
Bob Martin.
Why do they always come to me the third?
Because
time?
You're so
they like you, dear.
Start with me, but I would say doll clothes.
Doll clothes, doll house, and doll baby are the three. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
Yes, I'll pick doll house.
Doll house and baby's one. Let's find out if it's up there. We'll begin by revealing the $100 number. Doll face. Doll there. Face. We're looking for doll house. May we see the next one, please? Doll baby. All right, here's your last chance for doll house. Slide the big one. Yes, you got it. Congratulations. Yeah. All right. Bob, you've won $500, which means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now let's see how much more you're going to win with your second audience match. Good as blank. All right, three more stars.
My favorite Shanana Bowser again.
Good as gold.
Yeah! Brett?
Oh, good as gold. Good as, yes. Good as. Huh? Oh! I already said gold. Good as sold.
Good as sold. Okay.
Joyce.
Good as can be.
Good as can be. Yeah, good as can be, good as gold, and good as sold. You can choose one of those or think up one of your own.
I'm going to go with gold.
Yeah! Okay. Let's find out if good as gold is up there. Maybe you see the $100 number, please. Good as can be is there. Maybe see the next one. Good as new. We're looking for good as gold. Here's your last chance for the gold. Go. Another $500 multiplied by 10 makes another $5,000. Added to the previous $5,000, you've got a pot of $10,000 to shoot for, but you can double that stake if you have a lucky spin of the star wheel. Go, it must make one complete revolution, and good luck to you. Here we go. Let's see if he gets a double. If it stops in the gold star area, he's got it. If the light stays on, he's got it. Just barely out of the double, but $10,000 is a goodly sum to play for. Good luck to you. Stand there and face me if you would please there. Breanne, you ready?
Oh, yeah.
You will write your answer. He'll give us a verbal response. This is it. Blank hockey. Blank hockey. Okay, Bob, if you give us the answer that Brianna's written on the card, we give you $10,000. That's all there is to it. There it is, blank hockey.
Ice hockey.
Yeah!
Ice hockey.
Okay. Brianna, he says ice hockey will match it for the $10,000. What do you say?
I'm really sorry. I said ice.
Wow. Yeah. We have a total of $11,000. Congratulations to Bob McCrano. I guess he's happy. Who else is rooting for you out there?
I have a friend, Connie, and her daughter in the front row.
Okay. Got to do a little business with the man. I've got to come back and say goodbye to Bob McDonald. Didn't think of field hockey, did you? Just said ice hockey.
Ice,
huh? Well, it was very good for you because you ended up with $11,000. And we congratulate Bob McDonald. Join us next week for Match Game GM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive new improved Degree shampoo. Keeps hair clean longer because, unlike some shampoos, Degree contains no greasy peeling additives. And Star-Kissed Tuna, the good-tasting tuna. Only good-tasting tuna get to be Star-Kissed. And don't forget to tell them Charlie sent you. And Campfire Marshmallows, the original and still the best. So fresh, so fluffy, so downright delicious, Campfire Marshmallows. And Frederick Room Air Conditioners, quality built, dependable, and energy efficient. Put together better to last for years and save you a lot of money, furnished by Frederick. And a Master Mechanic 8-gallon shop vac from True Value Hardware Stores. You combine value and personal service in over 5,000 locations nationwide. And Turtle Extra Car Wax. Extra easy, extra durable, extra brilliant. Turtle Extra Car Wax in liquid or new soft paste. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.